These are our scroll saws. Scroll saws are fun. You can do many things with a scroll saw. You can do rip cuts. You can do cross cuts. You can also do tightly radius cuts. Here I'm going to install the blade. The scroll saw uses a very tiny blade. It has two pins on each end of it. I'm going to remove the throat plate, and I want to make sure as I'm installing the blade that the teeth are pointing down. After I have the blade in place, I'm going to apply the tension with the tension lever and snugly replace the throat plate. The throat plate helps support the material from underneath, but it also allows you to remove it and have access to the blade. Another adjustment that I need to make when working on the scroll saw is the hold down. The scroll saw has a reciprocating blade. That's one that goes up and down, and it can make the material vibrate quite a bit if you're not holding on to it. Again, safety is important. Make sure all loose articles of clothing are secure. I'm going to look for a good outlet to plug the scroll saw in. I want to make sure that I'm using a properly grounded outlet and that the cord is not damaged. I'm going to turn on the machine and I'm going to adjust the blade speed. There is a variable speed knob for adjusting the blade. You can slow it way down or you can turn it all the way up. Since I'm working with 3/4 inch stock, I'm going to have the blade turned up to full speed. It has to work a little bit harder, so I want to make sure that I can get as most out of the machine as I can. Right now I'm doing a cross cut. I'm going against the grain of the material, so I'm decreasing the length of my board. Now you might notice I do have to cut a little bit slower than what I did on the bandsaw, but it does make a pretty smooth cut. Now I'm going to make a tiny rip cut. I'm just working with some scrap pieces of wood for this demonstration, so I want to show you the different cuts that you can do on the scroll saw. Once again, it does go quite a bit slower than the bandsaw, but the nice thing about the scroll saw is there's several of them in the shop, and you can actually use them to cut out all the small pieces for your candy dispenser activity. You do need to be patient. Don't make the scroll saw work too hard. The blade is very narrow, so you want to feed it into the cutting edge very slowly. I've completed my tiny rip cut. Now I'm going to show you a tightly radiused cut. One advantage that the scroll saw has over the bandsaw is that you don't always have to make all the relief cuts when you're trying to cut a curve or any sort of irregular shape like that. As long as you move slowly, you can turn your piece sharply. You can cut very sharp curves. In fact, the curves that you can cut on the scroll saw are so sharp, it's sometimes referred to as a jigsaw, because you can almost make pieces that appear to be jigsaw puzzle pieces. Check this out. So I cut that notch on that piece of material without doing any relief cuts. There's my rip cut, and here's my cross cut, just to show you the variety of cuts that you can do on the scroll saw. When you are finished, make sure you grab the plug, not the cord, and disconnect it from electrical power. Clear your work area and put your pieces away.